So here it is, but it's weeks after the Olympics. You're with the Islanders now. They're going for the fifth straight Stanley Cup. Second game, Toronto, you score a hat trick. And there's a great Bobby Nystrom story you told me that goes with that day. Sort of cemented you right away with these guys.
So my dad was, I was a Canadiens fan, Guy Lafleur. He loved Toronto. So he drove up to watch my first game in person at Maple Leaf Gardens. And I don't know how it happened, but just this, it was almost kind of one of those things that just happened, meant to be. But I was able to score my first goal in front of my dad, in front of his favorite building, against his favorite team. He wasn't happy about that. He actually was happy. Then I somehow got a second goal, got an assist, somehow got a hat trick, got another assist. We won 11-6. Al Arbour came and kicked the trash can. He said, "You gave up six goals." He was upset. I'm serious. He was really upset, but somehow Bobby Nystrom and we were all 1, 2, and 3 stars. I was like, this can't be happening. And before that, I get run from behind by Jim Korn. And I turned around and I slashed him, and then Bobby Nystrom came in and just nailed him, hit him hard. So I received my first 2-minute penalty for slashing, I believe it was. And Bobby was a big guy, and Jim Korn was 6'4", and I just turned 19, and Bobby Nystrom turned to me on the left, and we're in Maple Leaf Gardens, and Don Cherry's going crazy. He said, "Kid, don't ask me any questions, go straight to the bench." And I almost said, "Okay, Mr. Nystrom." I did. And I literally skated right to the bench, and before I got to the bench, I remember Trotz stood up, Clark Gillies stood up, and I just turned, and Bobby Nystrom grabbed Jim Korn. To this day, he went right-handed, he went left-handed, he went right-handed, he threw about 22 punches to Jim Korn's one.
Whoa! Holy, he's better break it up. Korn's got a broken nose.
We got out, and the first thing my dad said, and I said, "I know now why these guys are champions. It's my second game. This guy took liberties, and Bobby Nystrom basically took care of him and let him know you don't do that." And I immediately fell to part of the team, and I knew that these guys are special because they stick up for each other like that. And my dad says, "Now you know why they're champions."